Welcome to BASF at K2019. Welcome in here at the BASF booth in Hall 5. Welcome out there on the live stream. Our next live talk will be about a topic which is of absolute particular interest at this year's K Fair, sustainability / circularity. We will be talking about a very interesting pilot project that BASF and Storopack joined. And I'm happy to introduce Charles Poisson from Storopack and Jesus Ocaña-Corral from BASF. Hi, good to have you.
Thank you for the invitation.
Thank you.
Charles, maybe because not everybody is familiar with what Storopack does, maybe you can describe a bit what Storopack stands for and what your role is.
Okay, thank you. So my name is Charles Poisson. I'm the R&D and Sustainability Director for Storopack, for the molding division. And Storopack is a family-owned company specialized on the production of plastic, on protective packaging. Protective packaging like cushioning, for example, all the cushioning system for void or with paper. And also to produce protective packaging from foam parts, like EPS, for different fields, like packaging, food or non-food, for pharma industry, like temperature control packaging, and also for technical parts for automotive, like bumpers or absorber, in case of impact of your car.
Okay. So we're going to talk about this box, actually. Not only this box, but everything that comes with this box. It looks like a normal packaging product made from EPS. Actually, it's not. It's a bit special, and maybe you can tell us a little more, why is it special?
Okay, thank you. So here we have three different examples of prototypes that we realized with the chem cycling material a few months ago. The first one, it's our new seafood box, so it's to transport fish inside. And here, why it's interesting, because it's a mass market product, so we need also volume for that. We need insulation, and we need to be also cost effective. And it's why this material is really interesting, because we achieve all these targets. And also, it's food approval, because we need to transport fish directly in contact with EPS. Okay. And so it's why it's one of the key advantage for that. A second application is for protective packaging. I think we have a picture here.
Yeah.
Here, so this part was realized with a partner called, a customer. It's Karcher, and it's to protect the new cleaner for floor.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's an electric one. And here we need, of course, protective performances. And what is interesting in this case is this part will be in the hand of the end user. Mm-hmm. And so this part can be put in the yellow bin. Mm-hmm. And it's also why it's interesting, these technologies, because we can reuse all the scraps, even if we don't have the possibility to sort all kind of plastics. So this one will be to the end user. Mm-hmm. And the last one, it's also for a completely other application. It's a temperature control packaging, so it's for the medical market. Mm-hmm. And inside, we will transport medicine, vaccine, or these kind of things. And we have to control and to be sure that the temperature inside will be always, for example, in this case, between 2 to 8 degrees during 96 hours, for example. Mm-hmm. And we have to maintain without external energy this. And here, with this material, we need to be really precise in terms of quality, in terms of healthy, in terms of all the approvals that we have to add. And also, it's a test that we realize with chem cycling in quite good conditions.
So this is all those boxes say styropor C-cycled. Jesus, tell us a bit more about chem cycling and EPS. Why is it important for BASF? What benefits does it have?
Well, as you know, chem cycling is one of the main pillars of the BASF strategy on sustainability. Yes, because with chem cycling, we want to create more value to the environment and to the society. But how? For example, for plastics, chem cycling can, of course, contribute to increase the recyclability of plastics in general, and can also develop a economy, which trends more in the circularity. Mm-hmm. Specifically for EPS, what does it mean? EPS is a 100% recyclable. This is a monomaterial, and in fact, there is a well-established recycling system. Mechanical, mechanical recycling. But there is still a fraction of EPS which is not sorted out. No? For example, a good example is this kind of packaging, or the typical EPS packaging you can find in the coffee machine. Mm-hmm. No? You dispose normally this packaging in the yellow bin or in the yellow bag, and due to economical reasons, this material is not sorted out. Mm-hmm. For this fraction of EPS, ChemCycling can fill the gap and can have a high contribution to the recyclability of such materials.
Charles, you already talked a lot about the requirements that you have for the different areas of application. So is this ChemCycled material, is this on the same level as the kind of virgin EPS normal material?
Yes.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. Without any difference in terms of cycle time, in terms of quality, in terms of... And just for example, we realized like a blind test for the test. Mm-hmm. We test it in two factories.
Yeah.
And we just inform at the end the technicians that transfer the materials, and without any significant difference.
Is this also the feedback that you are getting from your customers?
Yes, yes, because we start to show that. And what is important for us, it's also part of our strategy, is to focus on sustainable and energy-saving solutions. Mm-hmm. And it's not only facts, because today, just for example, we already 20% of our sales are coming from recycled or renewable materials or solutions. So, and we want to accelerate that. And of course, we have different options. We have mechanical recycling, what we just explained, and chemical recycling. And here we can use plastic scraps, where we cannot use for mechanical recycling, because we have to sort the material to use for EPS. Mm-hmm. So it's a good combination, and we have to, and also it's a good thing to improve the image of plastics, to stop the plastic waste, and the image of EPS also.
This is, I mean, the live talk is also called a pilot project. Mm-hmm. So I assume this is not being delivered in mass volumes. Can you tell us a little more about how the cooperation started? Was it Storopark asking BASF, or did we approach our customer?
Of course. This is a pilot project at a corporate level. And to start with this project, or the core of the project, is just to produce the pyrolysis oil. Mm-hmm. For this purpose, BASF, together with the technology providers, could produce this pyrolysis oil. Mm-hmm. This pyrolysis oil is made of mixed plastic waste, mm-hmm. and we are using a pyrolysis process. This is a thermochemical process where we can break down the polymer chain and produce this oil. Okay. After that, BASF was able to feed the first small quantity of this oil into the steam cracker. Mm-hmm. And afterwards, we could produce the first quantity of Styropor C-Cycle. This is the name of the chemically recycling Styropor. I would like to remark that the production of Styropor C-Cycle is based on the ChemCycling approach. This mm-hmm. is a mass balance approach where we can virtually allocate the equivalent quantity of pyrolysis oil we need for the production of Styropor.
Okay.
This is, just to understand this concept, is quite similar to the green energy.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a well-certificated process at BASF. After that, we send the material to Storopack, and then you can add the rest.
And just to explain, we tested the material for different application, and completely different application with different performances. So food, for food, for protective packaging, or for quality or thermal isolation. and as I explained, without any difference in terms of processing is or that, quality.
So there's no there's no changes necessary also to the production process.
No, same expansion process, same molding process, same mold. No change. So it's it's really interesting because you can
drop in.
This is the main advantage, yeah. I will say. Mm-hmm.
And it's the best way for the circularity of EPS also.
Yeah, that's important, of course. Yeah. Okay. So pilot project, of course, this is not the end. So how do we continue? How do we go from here? And where?
Okay. First of all, I would like to mention that chem cycling is nice. Or we are strongly convinced that can be a contribution to the recyclability of plastics, but this is not the solution. Mm-hmm. No, chem cycling is a complementary recycling technology, and it is necessary to develop the other existing technologies. As I said before, for example, for the B2B segment, there is a well-established mechanical recycling with a specific end of life, and we are convinced that it. Yeah, it has to be continued like that. Chem cycling is for a specific application and a specific fraction. Yeah. Huh? And after that, I would like to add that, we are in the pilot phase. We have a great team only focused on this project. Mm-hmm. And they have the aim to scale up the technology and start with the market rollout. But we don't expect that it happen in a short term. There are...
I would have one question to Charles because of what you mentioned. How strong do you feel the push also from your customers, from brand owners, to go into more sustainable packaging solutions?
As I explained, today our customers are quite happy with the performances of EPS. Performances, price ratio, food approval, thermal property, and something like that. And if we want to switch or to have alternatives, it's really important to be sure that this alternative will be better in terms of circularity or in terms of sustainability. And it's why it's a good combination, as you explained, with mechanical recycling or the other way. But in this case, we can keep the performances that we need, and also it's to reduce waste, food waste, and the rest. But we can improve because we can reuse standard waste that we cannot use today, because today it's incinerated or in landfill, and this is the best way to improve the loops. And this is a clear request from our customer to be better and to explain that, and also due to the context about plastic, it's the best option to speak about collection, about recycling, and about circularity.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for these insights. Thank you very much for showing these prototypes from the pilot project. Thanks a lot also to everybody who joined the live stream. We'll be back here in about 45 minutes from now with our next live talk. See you soon.
Bye.